Because if I have the whole population, if I somehow magically have every ATM withdrawal that ever happened to this ATM machine, I would have the whole population of data. We don't. We have 30 days. Right? We don't have the population. If I had the whole population, there's no mystery to what happened. I divide by this number. I divide by N. And the symbol for the population variance is this Greek letter, sigma. And this is, again, the sum of the squares. But if I had the population, I would know the population mean, which is mu. We don't know that. What we know is x bar, the sample mean, and you get the sample variance and sample standard deviation. Question. Well, why do I divide by n minus 1 then for the sample? Anybody have any idea? Statisticians are like finicky, I guess. That they're conservative. If I divide by 30 here, will I get a bigger or smaller number over here? Smaller, right? Divide by 30, this becomes, I don't know, 84, 83 or something like that, right? Smaller number. And that says that I think the total variation is smaller. Well, statisticians said, well, maybe we shouldn't be so enthusiastic. I only have 30 data points, right? You know, if I knew all the data points, I wouldn't feel bad about dividing by them if I had the population. But I only have 30 data points. So I'm going to arbitrarily make this number a little bigger so that my guess is more conservative. And that's the reason that that's going on. You know, if we knew the population in total, we would have no mystery, and this would be the population standard deviation, which would be sigma. Most of the time, we're left over here to work with a sample, which we have, which is a 3D data point. Questions on how to figure out sample population, or the sample standard deviation, sample variance. Okay, great. We have range, variance, and standard deviation. We're going to talk about Mr. Chubby Chub and the empirical rule for a moment.